Now I will show you the two MsgBox option in Access. MsgBox is a statement and function. Okay, now I will show you the difference of these two options. Let's start. First, I will create form, then I will save to MsgBox options. Then I will go to design, then I will put button to execute our MsgBox. So here I will make a hello world. So I will change to save this hello. Now I will show you the MsgBox statement. So MsgBox statement, this is useful but just only to passing message to the user without any interaction. This is simple. Again, I will select this one, unclick, and I will type MsgBox. Then since this is just only a MsgBox statement, I will put here hello world. Then will open and click. So this is the simple, this is the so-called again the MsgBox statement. Next, I will show you also the MsgBox function. Again, I will go to design, then I will add another button. But just only an action. Then here, send the action. Then go to event, then unclick. Here. Now we need to put some variable. So I put them x as integer, then x equals, now we will put our MsgBox here. MsgBox, then we'll put our function to prompt. We'll put, are you sure you want to proceed? Then we will call. Then next, we'll choose the button types. There's a lot of options here to choose. But for this sample, I will choose BV yes, no. So, meaning, this button types, it will generate us the two buttons or options, which is yes or no. Then, comma. Next is the title of the message box. So, I will put double quote, then you can put any title. So, which I will put processing. Then, I will put some dot. Then, I will close our function. So here, this is the message box statement without any interaction, just only to pass a message into the user. If you click that button, here you have an option to choose. So this is our function. Then this is the button types and this is the title. So if we will click the button, automatically it will ask, are you sure you want to proceed? Then we have some option to click yes or no button. Look here, it's only okay. And here, if you click this one, it will generate two buttons, which is yes or no. Then you can do some action. No, then you can choose also yes. So you have an option to interact. Okay. Next, we will add another button. I will show you also the another example of the message box function. Here I will just put action 2 because this is almost related with here, because this is a message box function. I will put CMD action 2, then on click event. Here I will put our variables dim result as integer. And again, we'll put our variable here, result equal, then our message box, then open bracket. Next, our function. So I will put, are you sure? Then we'll put again the button type. So I will choose first the VB OK cancel. So again, this will generate the two buttons, OK and cancel, for us to choose. Then I will put title, which is confirmation. This is only an example. Then we will close. Then I will put here debunk.print result. So again, this is our function, this is our variable. Then once we click our button, it will ask, are you sure? Then it give us two options to OK or cancel. Look, are you sure? So it's coming here, it's including VBA or cancel. So we need to modify that one. The issue here is we need to put double quote to separate, and here also. Now everything is fine. Then again, if we click that one, are you sure? Then you can select cancel, or you can select also. Okay, before here is yes or no. Then another option with the same button, we can add also. Here we will change the button type. We can choose also the VB abort ignore. So meaning this VB abort retry ignore, this will give us or generate three buttons. Okay, if I open, then I click, look, are you sure? So we have three options: abort, retry, and ignore. As you notice here, the default is abort. So whatever you, if we choose the button type, the first button, this is the default: abort, retry, and ignore. So we need to choose which button are default. So let's say ignore, we can make it default also, or retry. Okay, now I will close that one. Here, this one, since this is our button types, so no need to add comma. But what we want to do is, instead of comma, we'll just put a space, then plus. Now we can choose. So since we have three buttons, this VB default button one, this is for abort, and VB default button two, this is for retry, and if we choose this one, VB default button three, so this one will generate as our ignore is the default. So we will choose this one as our default. Lock. If we click this action 2, now our default is ignore before it's abort. So we will also replace to retry as our default. It's very straightforward, just replace number 2. Then if we click this one, automatically retry is our default. Now we need to put some symbol here, so we need to put some symbol like are you sure. So we will put, or we will add the symbol here like exclamation or critical symbol. Okay, the same button. Then here again, since we have already, we choose already this button type, now we need to add some symbol. Again, no need to put comma, just press space, then plus. Now we will choose baby critical, exclamation, information. So we will choose this one, exclamation, then try lock. This is the symbol to display. Are you sure? You can modify also. We can choose another symbol. Again, that's why I remove plus, because if we will click plus, automatically it give us an option, so no need to type. So baby critical, this will give us a red X critical lock. Are you sure? Then another, also instead of baby critical, we can choose also information. This information, not exclamation. We've done already this one. Information, this one. VB information. Just to show to the user the option. Lock. Are you sure? So we have three buttons to execute. Again, this is the sample of MsgBox statement, and this one, this is the MsgBox function. So we have two examples for MsgBox. Thank you and God bless.